Ioan Iacob, pictor născut în 1954, la Bieta, în județul Sibiu. M-am stabilit în 1975 la Düsseldorf, orașul în care am studiat la Academia de Arte, la profesorul Gothard Graubner, care a fost un mare maestru al culorii. Pictura în sine nu ar trebui descrisă. Ea își dezvăluie și își găsește ecoul în ochii privitorului. Ca mică descriere, totuși, sunt pictor, sunt un pictor al culorii, lucru pe care doresc să-l menționez în mod deosebit, al culorii organice. Lucrez în ulei, lucrez cu apa și praful colorate. Vezi acuarela, pastel, cărbune, etc.
He chooses various subjects with an aim to lay the pure, organic painting on the canvas. Perhaps he best learned the lesson on colors from his professor Gothard Graubner, one of the greatest abstract colorists in recent art at the Kunstakademie Düsseldorf, where he began to study in 1977, having relocated to West Germany 2 years before. Previously, Ioan Iacob's paintings were shown together with works of Tiziano Vecellio, El Greco, Rembrandt, William Turner, Eugène Delacroix, René Magritte, Man Ray, Francis Bacon, Max Beckmann, Monahatum, Cyrine Schat, Gerhard Richter, Christo, in museums such as Kunstpalast in Düsseldorf. Ioan Iacob's artworks can also be seen in German and Romanian museums. He has had both group and solo exhibitions in the United States, Israel, Germany, Belgium, Holland, and Romania. His works can be found in private collections in Berlin, Düsseldorf, and Brussels. Among the committed collectors of Ioan Iacob's works, we can mention Georg Böckmann and Willy Kemp.
Vorbim despre talent, inteligență, vigoare, revelație, imaginație, profunzime, etc. Toate aceste ingrediente fundamental necesare în alcătuirea operei de artă, sau mai bine spus, conglomeratului de artă, sunt insuficiente fără elementul de bază, și anume sensibilitatea. În cazul meu, vorbesc de sensibilitatea în culoare. Acesta este un credo al meu. Un exemplu edificator ar putea fi o natură statică, care nu trebuie să rămână doar o natură statică. Ea poate deveni un univers întreg.
In his paintings, Ioan Iacob outlines the Baroque atmosphere existing in the works of Diego Velázquez and brings up a whole display of costumes specific to the 17th century. Starting with his student years, the German painter of Romanian origin developed a passion for the artworks of Diego Velázquez. He made an early habit of visiting the museums of Kunsthistorische Vienna and Prado of Madrid on a regular basis, where he could admire the works of the Spanish artist in their original form.
În momentul de față se derulează expoziția mea numită Vademecum, în paranteză, însoțește-mă, vino cu mine la Galeria Carol din București, unde prezint printre altele, o mare parte a ciclului infantelor, un ciclu important la care lucrez de câțiva ani.
Not any less true is that the infanta theme takes a lot of space in our dedicated exhibition. Carol Galleries were founded by Iulia Deme in 2015 in Bucharest, Romania. Starting with 2018, Carol Galleries have had a consistent exhibition schedule created by managing curator Aluca Boloiu. The curatorial program focuses mainly on exhibitions acting as 70s and 80s revival of the Romanian diaspora art, highlighting the innovative approach of the artists residing abroad. Another direction of the gallery's activity consists of launching emerging artists who tackle unconventional environments in painting, sculpture, installations and new media. Postmodernist reinterpreted, the Infanta paintings of Ioan Iacob show an enlarged approach, most often a barely sketched face, but with an emphasis on dresses and hand gestures. Each of the Infantas was portrayed wearing a handkerchief, a fan or a muff. In most of the paintings of the 17th century, the handkerchief is seen as a symbol of affection and fidelity, being offered with an embroidered monogram on it. We noticed that the Infantas showed with a handkerchief in our displays were portrayed from very early ages until the advent of their marriage in order to be introduced to their future spouses. Quite frequently illustrated is Margaret Teresa of Spain, favorite child of Philip IV, who was betrothed at a very early age and had to marry her maternal uncle, Leopold I. After her father's death, the Infanta's promise of marriage was fulfilled at the age of 15, followed by her move to Austria. This Infanta is also the central figure of the Velázquez painting Las Meninas, where the little girl is standing in the middle of the royal court. In his canvases, Ioan Iacob highlights the majestic, overflowing dresses designed with a vertugadin, a structure used under the dress and meant to support the skirt in the desired form. Coming out in the age of Renaissance, the vertugadin, a name derived from verdugo, meaning green hood in French, is the forefather of the crinoline dress, recorded much later in the 19th century France of the Second Empire. In an atmosphere of strictness and seriousness, the Spanish court costume followed the tradition of the Burgundy fashion, full of pompousness. According to the Burgundy tradition, the hair was all tied up and covered with a small toque.
Un atelier este, nu, mai bine altfel spus, atelierul meu este o cochilie, este un cuib, este o colibă, este o promenadă, este un vârf de munte, uneori atelierul este un uragan, alteori este locul în care ascult muzică, alteori este locul în care citesc poezie, uneori este locul inundat de lumină. Dar nu la urma urmelor, atelierul este locul în care lucrez.
Along with the Infanta thematic, Ioan Iacob has on display a number of other themes: still lifes, curtains, houses, books and suitcases. Starting with the Velázquez atmosphere, Ioan Iacob guides us from one place to another throughout the exhibition, pointing to a mini archive of his works included in suitcase. A symbol of archiving, but also one of traveling, the case also appears in a work called La Boîte en Valise by Marcel Duchamp, which contains miniature replicas of over 70 of the most important works of the French artist. On the other side, the theme is also a symbol of relocation, if we consider that Marcel Duchamp lived for a period of his lifetime in Paris, then moved to New York, and finally came back to Paris. Similarly, We could say this about Ioan Iacob, originating from Biertan, then moving to Düsseldorf in the 70s, the artist takes with him the melancholy of the Transylvanian houses and landscapes, often shown in his paintings, and more recently in the small sculpture objects that seem to be mobile testimonies of his birthplace. If his minimalist sculptures illustrate houses which underline the origin of the Romanian artist, alternatively, the volumes of books existing in his painted compositions prove a universal cultural identity. Therefore, Vademecum, the title of the exhibition, is not incidental, but rather an invitation of the artist for us to take as a reference point the book and everything connected with reading, culture, and widespread knowledge. In a technology-dominated world, the suggestion of the author is not to give up the printed book, but consider it as a landmark or, alternatively, a source of debate. The curtain's theme, both protecting and unveiling, has been used from the days of yore. If in the Old Testament writings it separated the sacred space from the profane space, in the fresco representations of the 14th century before Christ, in Pompeii and Herculaneum, the curtain had a practical role and a decorative one as well. In the 17th century, the curtain becomes a theater decoration, as shown in the paintings of Diego Velázquez, whom we know is Ioan Iacob's favorite. Although well outlined with his specific themes, Ioan Iacob considers most of his compositions still lives. More often than not, the artist of Romanian origin confesses that the subject chosen is rather a pretext to lay color to canvas in order to make it live and pulsate as sensitive matter.
Despre pandemie, despre acest un an și jumătate de house arrest, de izolare la domiciliu, nu pot să spun decât că pentru mine personal a fost foarte bine. Am amânat două, trei expoziții și am descoperit foarte, foarte mult timp liber, timp în care m-am putut concentra asupra acelor pânze începute, pe care de fapt le credeam gata, dar care s-au dovedit a fi insuficiente, așa că am avut o perioadă foarte bună. Nu regret deloc această perioadă de izolare, acest cuvânt fiind pus între ghilimele. Încerc să schițez o idee de mesaj citându-l pe Nichita Stănescu, a cărei frumoasă poezie se numește Vedere în acțiune. Da, aceasta este esența. Privirea noastră poate fi educată, poate fi cizelată. Și aș dori să sugerez tuturor celor care sunt interesați de a privi, să își mențină privirea în permanentă, în acțiune. Vă mulțumesc!